guys, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm sharing with you 5 tips to prepare for a new school year, as well as a short list of things you can do to stay productive over the summer holidays. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's get started. The first thing on my list is to make a pre-uni or pre-new school year to-do list, so you know exactly what you need to finish before September rolls around. I like to write out my responsibilities on paper first, dividing them into the 4 main categories of academics, extracurriculars, personal, and something new for this year, which is adulting. I'll start by writing down some tasks under each category, as well as set a specific deadline for it if applicable. Then I will transfer all of this information onto a Notion template, and here is how I'm setting that up. I will have the exact template linked in the description box if you're interested in using it for yourself. For the template, I am simply starting by making a new page and inserting an inline table. In the table, I included the following headings: task name, checkmark for completion, category, due dates, and notes. And if I ever find it necessary, I will divide the categories further from the 4 that I started with. Now all you have to do is fill out the table. So some tasks I'm looking to work on over the next 2 months include previewing some content for my courses next year, applying for different clubs and organizations, setting up a Notion page for a second year, as well as getting ready to move out. Now just keep in mind that this list might look different depending on your age and your priorities this summer. My next tip is to work on building healthy habits, whether that's fixing and keeping a proper sleep schedule, working out, studying consistently, eating healthy, drinking enough water, reading, or whatever else it may be. I find it super important to form healthy habits because a lot of the times we say things like, oh, I don't feel motivated to work out, or I have no motivation to study for my upcoming test. Now during the school year, when everything gets busy and stressful, what I've found is that relying on motivation alone can become really difficult as the year progresses. Instead, the emphasis should be on forming habits and having the discipline to do what you should do, whether or not you have 100% of the motivation. Of course, it won't be easy in the beginning, but be patient. Do the same things at the same time every day, and soon you'll feel a difference in your daily routine, making being productive much easier. My third piece of advice is to get involved in activities outside of your classroom. Although most of the content on my channel is focused around studying and, you know, grades are important and all that, but they're not the only thing that matters. Through applying and getting involved with causes that you care about, whether that's through a volunteering or internship position, you get to meet a lot of like-minded individuals in the process, and you really get the chance to develop some personal as well as technical skills. This piece of advice goes out to most of my high school viewers because these skills and experiences you gain early on will definitely help you when it comes time to apply for university as well as applying for clubs at university. It's not too complicated to get started. Just start by polishing your resume and always be on the lookout for opportunities that you may be interested in. Now, it might be hard to actually find your first position, but you know, we all start somewhere, and I'm sure the experience will be worth it at the end. Moving on, my next tip is to learn a useful skill that you wouldn't otherwise learn in school. For example, one skill that I'm working on, along with a couple of others, is cooking, which brings me to mention the sponsor of today's video, HelloFresh. HelloFresh is a meal kit service that offers a ton of different delicious seasonal recipes and comes with freshly cut produce and pre-measured ingredients delivered right to your door in sustainable and recyclable packaging, making the entire process of cooking a lot more environmentally friendly, accessible, and affordable. As someone who will be living alone in September, HelloFresh has really taken the stress off of meal planning and shopping for groceries, allowing me to have a healthy dinner ready in less than 30 minutes after a long day of classes. As I've mentioned before, they also have a ton of different recipes that you can choose from, so your meals will definitely not get repetitive. And if you ever need to skip a meal or change a delivery date, then HelloFresh will always cater to fit your lifestyle. Finally, HelloFresh is committed to giving back to the community. They've donated over 4 million meals in 2020 and will continue to do so this year. So with all of that said, if you're interested, head over to HelloFresh.com and use my code REVISING14 to get 14 free meals, including free shipping. Finally, my last piece of advice is to spend quality time alone or with your friends or family. Call your friends to chat or to hang out or go on a picnic if that's safe to do so in your region, and really just socialize and interact. I'm sure the pandemic and the whole online situation has deprived us of social interactions, so it's definitely worth catching up now. While it's a bit easier to figure out something to do with your friends, sometimes I struggle to come up with ideas as to how I should spend my time alone. So I've quickly put together a list of things you can do this summer on your own, ranging from items that are more school-related and productivity-based to pure entertainment. Personally, I'm going to spend a good amount of my time, or I've already spent a good amount of my summer, rewatching Island and any new and hyphen content that's been released. So I've definitely been having a good time. But with all of that said, honestly, at the end of the day, really just enjoy your summer. Because what I've come to realize is that we will honestly all adapt and learn when the time comes. And when we make plans to preview certain content in preparation for a course we're taking, we're really just trying to cope with the stress that comes with being exposed to something new. So whichever course it is that you're taking, you will honestly do fine whether or not you spend your summer studying for it. So if you are planning to study, just be wise and be smart about the decisions you're making, and do not burn out before the school year even starts. And that is it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and check out more of my content. And all of my social media, podcasts, and website will be linked in the description box below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys!